नमस्कार, गुड आफ्टरनून। आप देख रहे हैं पीएम ई विद्या चैनल्स और एनसीईआरटी का ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल। मैं हूं राहुल और हम लेकर हाजिर हैं अपना अगला लाइव इंटरैक्टिव सेशन लेकर, जो कि है साइंस का। और साइंस में एक ऐसा टॉपिक जिसकी हम सबको बहुत ज़्यादा ज़रूरत है, और वो है व्हाई डू वी फॉल इल, हम बीमार क्यों पड़ते हैं। हालांकि आप इसके पार्ट वन और पार्ट टू पहले ही पढ़ चुके हैं, तो जाहिर सी बात है कि आज आप कुछ रिकैप भी करेंगे पार्ट वन और पार्ट टू का, एंड देन विल मूव अहेड फॉर द पार्ट थ्री। इन बिटवीन अगर आपके पास कोई क्वेश्चन होता है तो ज़रूर उसे पूछिएगा, क्योंकि अक्सर हम कुछ ना कुछ थोड़ी बहुत बीमारी से जूझते ही रहते हैं, और अभी तो वैसे बीमारी मंडरा ही रही है, तो वो भी उससे बच के रहना है। और सावधानी सबसे ज़्यादा ज़रूरी है, जैसा कि डॉक्टर्स प्रिस्क्राइब करते रहते हैं, कुछ प्रोटोकॉल्स हमें फॉलो करने हैं। तो आप चाहें तो हमारे एक्सपर्ट से क्वेश्चन पूछने के लिए एक टोल फ्री नंबर का इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं, विच इज़ 8800440559। और कोई डिस्क्रिप्टिव क्वेश्चन इफ यू हैव, यू कैन सेंड अस एन ईमेल ऑन dth.class9@cieet.nic.in, जो हमारी क्लास नाइन्थ की एक स्पेसिफिक ईमेल आईडी है। सो आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट आवर गेस्ट फॉर टुडेज सेशन, डॉक्टर प्रियंका वार्ष्णेय। आप असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर हैं। प्रियंका जी नमस्कार, गुड आफ्टरनून एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम।
थैंक यू राहुल जी, हाउ आर यू?
आई एम गुड, थैंक यू वेरी मच। होप यू आर डूइंग वेल एंड सेफ, और आपका परिवार भी सुरक्षित होगा, ऐसी हमारी आशा है।
Thank you. Yes, with God grace, we are all fine, and I'm just praying and hoping same for everybody.
Yes,
that everybody should be safe, everybody should be healthy in this
way. That's why I request you to please focus on your subject. आपने जो विषय का चुनाव किया है, which is very important, why do we fall ill? मैंने इसीलिए अपनी बात में ये बात जोड़ी कि अक्सर हम थोड़ी बहुत कुछ ना कुछ परेशानियों से जूझते ही रहते हैं, कभी कफ है, कभी कोल्ड है, कभी बैक एक है, कभी कुछ है, तो लेकिन ऐसा होता क्यों है? चलिए आप पढ़ाइए, मैं देखता हूँ कि हमने क्या पार्ट वन और पार्ट टू में पढ़ा था। आई एम श्योर वी शुड हैव सम रीकैप पार्ट थ्री पढ़ने से पहले।
बिल्कुल, थैंक यू राहुल जी, और मैं बिल्कुल आपने सही कहा, क्योंकि ये सेशन थ्री है, तो मैं पार्ट वन और पार्ट टू का भी थोड़ा सा एक या दो मिनट में स्टूडेंट्स को हाईलाइट करना चाहूंगी
प्लीज,
कि हमने क्या क्या शेयर किया है, सो दैट एनी टाइम दे कैन गो बैक टू दोस सेशंस एंड दे कैन ऑलवेज सी द कंटिन्यूटी ऑफ व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड सो फार।
ओके,
सो अ वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम श्योर ऑल ऑफ यू आर हेल्दी, फिट एंड फाइन, एंड यू आर इंश्योरिंग मैक्सिमम लर्निंग। So let's start today's session, and as you can see, I am going to talk about from your chapter 13, class 9, that name of the chapter is Why Do We Fall Ill? So as Rahul sir has said, we have talked a lot about the concept of health and other associated aspects. Let's have a very quick look into what we have done so far. In my previous sessions, I have discussed the broad concept of health. There we talk a lot about what the health is and what the health is not also. What is, you know, usually the misconception, I would say, about the concept of health, that health is just being disease-free. But we had talked a lot about various contributory factors which contribute in sustenance and acquiring a good health. We had also talked about the significance of health. And in detail, with the help of various issues and I would say case studies, we had talked about the personal and community aspects related to health. In my previous sessions, I have, tried to differentiate between the concept of health and being disease-free. So all of us were discussing about it, and I could make out this point in the previous session that not just the idea of having disease-free makes me healthy. So if I want to be healthy, I need to include so many aspects like my personal health, my social health, my emotional health, and of course my socioeconomic factor and other things are contributing in health. We had talked about what the disease is and what are its different causes. And last session, the last topic that we discussed was the concept of acute and chronic diseases. So with this, let's start the new topic in our class today. Major focus of my discussion today is going to be understanding various causes of disease.
Okay.
In this, we will be talking about infectious and non-infectious diseases.
Okay.
What do we mean by a disease being infectious in nature? And there are certain diseases which are non-infectious also. So we will be talking about it. And after that, we will be discussing the concept of antibiotics, because this is a very widely known thing that everybody these days talks about, you know, taking the antibiotics. Antibiotics,
yes,
are very important, and we should visit the doctor and we should ask for some antibiotics. I have seen many of my friends also who the first instinct is that if some problem is there, I need to take some antibiotic. Without antibiotic,
yes,
I'm not going to be okay. So I am going to talk about this also, Rahul sir.
Mm-hmm.
And then I will be talking about how the infectious disease spreads from one person to another.
Okay.
And Rahul sir, in this I have also tried to include the COVID-19 pandemic also. This is also one of the
which is very, very mandatory to discuss, I think.
Yes.
Right.
So I have tried to include this also.
Please.
So let's start today's discussion with first understanding the various causes of diseases. So students, when we talk about various causes of diseases, for the sake of systematic understanding, first we need to understand that there are certain immediate causes of diseases which are very clear to us. You know, when we talk about disease, then these causes are very clear to us. They are very immediate causes. Like if I am having some infectious disease, or I am having some non-infectious disease, for example, common cold, and then COVID-19, these are considered as infectious diseases. And when we talk about non-infectious diseases, like, you know, high blood pressure and diabetes and cancer for that matter, they are known as non-infectious diseases. So these are very immediate and obvious things that we know that this is the cause of this particular disease. But apart from that, there are many contributory aspects also which lead to a disease, and which are often they are hidden form. They are not very clear to us. So many times we are not able to relate why a particular disease is happening to one person and not to the other person. So it's not always that if I am infected by, let's say, some bacteria or some virus or some fungus, then not everybody gets the disease. So why one particular person is getting the disease and why not other person is getting the disease is also influenced by various contributory factors. So we really need to understand, apart from immediate causes of any disease, equally important aspect is the contributory factors which are leading to a particular disease. And as you can see, I have tried to put together some important contributory aspects, which is one of them is unhealthy conditions, public facilities. For right. example, I am getting typhoid fever. Mm-hmm. I am having cholera. Okay. So these diseases are caused by unhealthy, unhygienic conditions. For okay. example, if I am eating some food from a roadside mm-hmm. and this is not covered and a lot of flies are there, a lot
right.
of, the chances of getting them infected by various causative agents is there. So I am thinking I am just purchasing the food and eating it. But yes. unhealthy conditions, because these are not visible. If some yes. virus is there, some bacteria is there, it is not visible to my naked eye. So I feel I am eating the healthy food. And many times people are very perplexed and surprised that I ate the clean food, but then how did I get the disease? So we really need to understand unhealthy conditions and public facilities, like, you know, clean water, clean food, and clean toilets, I would say, are very, right. very important.
Yes, yes.
Yes. Sir, so this is something I think students really need to understand, the concept of hygiene and cleanliness, because they are the major factors, I would say, which lead to the immediate cause of disease. So if some virus is coming, some bacteria is coming, I'm coming in contact of some fungus, or I'm having fungal skin infection, uh-huh. then the role of my surrounding is also very important. Apart from that, if my surrounding is clean, or maybe some source of infection is there, if I have very weak immune system, then this also leads to the infection. As I just said, that many of the children or maybe adults, they get the disease and many of them do not. It depends on our immune system, how strong we are, how developed our immunity system is there. Immunity system of any individual is the fighting capacity against the diseases. So if my immune system is strong, then I am able to fight many of the infections, many of the diseases, and I do not develop the disease. Though I may come in contact with any infection, but I do not develop that disease. But if my immune system is very weak, then immediately I'll get the infection. So we need to have nutritious food for that matter. And of course, the nutritious food availability, affordability right. is also one of the social major, and major economic factor. And community factor.
Yes.
It varies across socioeconomic strata. So when we talk about science, we don't have to forget social science. We don't have to forget economics. We don't have to forget environment. We have to integrate and understand all these things in totality. Apart from that, I just said poverty. If we are not able to afford clean conditions, hygienic surrounding, or nutritional food, this is also one of the contributory factors in causing the disease. And last but not the least, genetic factors are also very important. If some individuals are genetically prone, genetically means the gene, the DNA that I am getting and inheriting from my parents, if the genes have more vulnerability towards any particular disease, then you have higher chances of getting the disease. So many, many diseases are genetic also in nature. Many times when you have some disease, some problem, you visit the doctor and then doctor say this disease is particularly genetic in nature because maybe you have inherited some gene from the parents or maybe forefather and foremothers, and that's why you are facing this problem. So this was a broad, I would say, the flow chart showing different causes of disease.
Right.
Rahulji, with your permission, I would like to move ahead.
Yes, yes, please go ahead.
Thank you. So students, I have developed this division of infectious diseases and non-infectious diseases. Uh-huh. As you can see, infectious diseases are those diseases which are caused by various microorganisms such as bacteria, virus, protozoa, fungus and worms. In 9th class, there is a chapter about the biological diversity also. I'm sure you would have read about the biological diversity and the 5 kingdom classification by R.H. Whittaker. There we see that there is a group Monera, Protista, and other groups are there. So many organisms which are belonging to these groups such as bacteria, virus, protozoa, and fungus and worms like Ascaris and all, they have been found to be the major causative agents of causing various diseases, and these diseases are known as infectious diseases. So the meaning of infection is that they may lead to the infection of another person also. For example, if I am suffering from a particular disease,
right,
and I come in contact with you,
right,
then through air or through, yes, water or through food or through close contact,
right,
then I may pass on that infectious agent to you as well.
Yes.
Rahulji, these days I think all of us have become very, yes, cautious about it, because
agreed,
for the last 1.5 years,
mm-hmm,
we've been struggling and listening a lot about COVID-19, yes, pandemic, and all of us know the strict guidances that you have to cover your face, you have to wear the mask, even the,
yes,
double mask has been suggested by the experts. So the reason is only that this is the infectious disease, and by chance if I am not aware and I am carrying that virus with me,
yes,
in my respiratory system, and I don't cover my mouth, I am exposing others also for the,
yes,
risk of getting the
rate of spread is very high.
Yes, yes.
Right.
You are very correct, because this is very infection, and all of us, I think, have seen the crisis and the issues that we faced during the second wave of pandemic. And
mm-hmm,
we really need to be very, very taking all the precautions, and we really need to be very active for that. We don't have to take any, we should not be careless in any way, I would say to students. And the example, students, that you can see is that, like common cold that we have been seeing, common cold, bachcho mein bhi ho jata hai, bado mein bhi ho jata hai, common cold. COVID-19, as I just said, influenza, malaria, tetanus, dengue, typhoid, elephantiasis, ascariasis, ये सारी जो diseases हैं, ये example हैं infectious diseases, ठीक है? तो इनका जो possibility है, वो ये है, they may lead to the infection to the other person. They are communicable. They can go from one person to the another person. When you see the other aspect, that is non-infectious diseases. So, not all the diseases are infectious in nature and they are caused by bacteria, virus and fungus, etc. Many of the diseases do not have any external source. They might have internal cause. For example, cancer. There has been a lot of research in the cancer, and people and researchers are trying to find out the exact reason. But so far, exposure to the ultraviolet light, some genetic factors and hidden lifestyle, which is, you know, many times not known. People get really surprised, how have I got this cancer when they are diagnosed with it. But no external source is there. This is not infectious in nature. For example, if, God forbid, I develop cancer, then the people who are taking care of me, who are in my surrounding, they do not have any danger of getting infection from me. So this is not infectious in nature. Apart from that, I think many of you would have known, maybe you know, the elders in the family or neighborhood having developed this disease known as high blood pressure and diabetes. So this has become a lifestyle disease. People say that when you are not eating good food, healthy food, balanced diet, and a lot of stress is there, which is leading to this disease. But again, it is not caused by any infectious agent. It is not caused by any virus or bacteria or fungus for that matter. If you develop diabetes or high blood pressure, it is because, mainly because of the lifestyle reasons. And also, in case of diabetes, it has been found that some roots or reasons might be there related to the genetic aspect. But majorly it is lifestyle. If we are not doing exercise and if we are eating high sugar content and if we are not taking the protein and other balanced diet, then we have higher chances of developing the diabetes. So this is the broad division of having infectious disease and non-infectious disease.
Okay.
So let's see. Infectious agents responsible for infectious disease majorly belong to the biological classification categories, that is bacteria, virus, fungi, protozoa and worms of different kinds. तो इनको हमें याद रखना है कि usually देखने को यही मिलता है कि इन groups से ज़्यादा positive agents होते हैं। जैसे मैंने example दिया bacterial disease का, typhoid fever, cholera, tuberculosis, anthrax, ये सारे examples हैं bacterial causes के, means they are caused by the bacteria. If you see typhoid जो है वो salmonella typhi से होता है human beings में और इसमें जो bacteria होता है that enters into the small intestine through the contaminated food and water and it migrates to the other organ, the blood. Symptoms of typhoid may be high fever, weakness, stomach pain, constipation, headache and loss of food. These are some of the symptoms that are usually seen in the people suffering from typhoid. Another example of bacterial infection is pneumonia. So this I would say the bacteria which is responsible for pneumonia is Streptococcus pneumoniae and it causes pneumonia and it infects the alveoli of lungs. So this is very, I would say, not a very good thing because we have seen many people who were suffering from COVID-19 also in recent past. We have seen that if the treatment was not proper and if their body did not support them, then they developed this pneumonia. So again, they had to take treatment for pneumonia. So the cause was viral. The virus was caused for COVID-19, but due to weak immunity and not proper treatment, they developed this bacterial disease also by the Streptococcus pneumoniae. So if virus is infecting you and your body is not prepared, so it's not always that virus is going to be reason for it. You may sometimes have to go for the medicines which have to act against the bacteria also. Because your body has become weak, then bacteria might also attack it. So this was also one of the case. The symptoms, I would say, sir, of pneumonia are fever, chills, and cough and headache. This has been seen that these are the common characteristics of people who are suffering from pneumonia.
Okay.
So when we talk about tetanus, we say that this is caused by Clostridium tetani, the bacteria which is responsible for that. And this bacteria is found in the soil and animals and human intestine. And the symptom of tetanus, muscle contraction, breathing problems, and lockjaw. These are the symptoms of tetanus.
Okay.
Now let's have a look at the viral causes of infection. Like when we have to talk about it, we see that common cold, influenza, dengue fever, AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, we talk about, and also COVID-19, they are the viral in nature. COVID-19 ke bare mein maine abhi abhi puri baat kari aur aapko bataya. और ये भी मैं इसमें ऐड करना चाहूंगी अपनी बात में कि COVID-19 के लिए जब हम बात करते हैं तो दिस इज द वायरस व्हिच इज कॉजिंग इट एंड ऑल ऑफ अस नो आई थिंक बाय नाउ ऑल ऑफ अस नो दैट दिस वायरस रिमेन्स सस्पेंडेड इन द एयर सो वी शुड नॉट थिंक इफ वी आर गोइंग टू एनी प्लेस एंड सम पर्सन इज नॉट देयर देन वी कैन रिमूव अवर मास्क वी शुड नॉट डू दैट बिकॉज वी रियली डोंट नो मे बी 5 मिनट्स बैक सम पर्सन हैज पास्ड and he or she may have not worn the mask also and if he or she was infected and the virus came out in the air then this virus can remain suspended in the air for some time and we also have the chances of getting the virus
right.
So this is also very important in case of COVID-19 and yeah COVID-19 spreads majorly by coughing and sneezing and that's the reason the mask is suggested that we have to wear the mask
right
and one important thing many times people say that we will take antibiotic for it so
yes,
it's
my
something
question,
that
my question is you know I have already this question regarding this from our YouTube channel also because aapne aapka jo previous slide tha usme jo aapne list kiya jo aapne list out kiya tha bimariyon ko those are the most common problems aur aapne COVID-19 joda abhi wo pichle saal डेढ़ साल mein ek common problem hamare sath hamari life mein used to ho gayi hai so most of the time we see people you know suffering from cold common cold and they take antibiotics are these effective and how do these work matlab hamesha unko hi kyon tawajjuh di jati hai life mein
I think you have raised a very appropriate question Rahul sir and this gives me an opportunity to talk a little more about it because I have also seen many people be it the young age people or middle age or the senior people many times I see the common perception is that antibiotics are the solution of everything
Yes.
Without knowing the exact nature of antibiotics. So
yes.
Antibiotics are those chemicals, those medicines which are acting against a certain chemical process which is taking against any microorganism, which may be the causative. For example, if some bacteria is causing some disease too.
Gee.
So bacteria has cell wall.
Mm-hmm.
So antibiotic which that particular bacteria will stop the formation of the cell wall of that bacteria.
Okay.
But if you are taking antibiotic against the causative agent of virus, then virus do not have cell wall. So when they do not have cell wall and they are not dependent on cell wall, then even if you are taking the antibiotic and it is breaking the cell wall is not there in the virus. So it is not going to be effective against the virus. It can be effective against those bacteria who have cell wall and it breaks the cell wall formation, the process of cell wall formation. That's why they are not able to survive and their multiplication stops. So we should not in each and every case, you know, run after that we really need to take some antibiotic because they may or may not be effective. And in, I think in adverse way, it may affect our body. If we are taking too much antibiotic, then the bacteria which might be there, we are not giving it for virus, some bacteria may become mutant. And next time there is some infection or some, you know, problem is there, then that antibiotic will not be effective. So too much antibiotic too many times should be avoided until and unless your doctors are advising you, you should not go for antibiotic.
Right.
And definitely not against any disease which is viral in nature, because this is not going to be effective.
जी जी तो यहाँ पर डॉक्टर प्रियंका ये कह रही हैं कि घरों में जो भी डॉक्टर विद्यमान हैं जो कि डॉक्टर नहीं है वो डॉक्टर की बिना सलाह के इस प्रकार की दवाइयाँ ना लें, पहले डॉक्टर से कंसल्ट करें फिर डॉक्टर बने तब ज़्यादा बेहतर रहेगा। ये आई जस्ट वुड लाइक टू ऐड दिस ऑन अ लाइटर नोट, क्योंकि हम अक्सर ऐसा करते हैं कि बिना सोचे समझे एंटीबायोटिक का इंटेक बढ़ा देते हैं या ज़्यादा लेते हैं, उससे हमें जो प्रॉब्लम्स होती हैं हम उसके बारे में अनअवेयर होते हैं। और यहाँ पर हमारे इस प्रोग्राम के माध्यम से भी हम ये बताना चाहते हैं कि आप ऐसा ना करें। हमेशा आपको डॉक्टर जब जाते हैं, जब वो गुस्सा होता है वो अक्सर ये कहता है कि खुद डॉक्टर क्यों बने आप, उसका कारण यही होता है कि आप अपनी सेहत बनाना तो चाह रहे थे बेहतर लेकिन वो ख़राब हो गई। क्यों? क्योंकि आपने ऐसी दवाई ली जिसकी आपको ज़रूरत ही नहीं थी। तो मैं डॉक्टर प्रियंका से गुजारिश करूंगा कि वे आगे बढ़े, बिकॉज वी हैव हार्डली 8 मिनट्स इन दिस सेशन।
यस, थैंक यू राहुल जी, आपने बहुत ही आम भाषा में और बहुत सटीक तरह से मेरी मदद करी है
जी।
ये बात समझाने में और पास ऑन करने में कि जैसे कि आपने कहा कि हमें नीम हकीम खतरेजान नहीं बनना चाहिए
जी।
तो उस तरह की चीजों से हमें बचना चाहिए और करेक्ट साइंटिफिक नॉलेज हमें डेवलप करनी चाहिए।
यस,
लेट्स मूव अहेड स्टूडेंट्स। सो डेंगू फीवर इज ऑल्सो वायरल इन नेचर and fungal infection की जब हम बात करते हैं, so I think you would have heard about various causes of fungus infection such as ringworm of the body, ringworm of the scalp, and cutaneous candidiasis and yeast infection. Even I would say fungus infection is quite common in skin. Many times we see the white patches on our skins and we get very surprised from where these white patches are coming. So they may be because a lot of moisture is there in your surrounding, a lot of, you know, water vapor is there in the surrounding. And if the proper hygiene is not being maintained, then some viruses might, fungus might be there in the air and they may get stick to a skin and that may lead to the fungal infection. So fungal infection is also there. These are majorly leading to the skin problems, skin diseases. Protozoan source of infection is also there. The microorganisms which are belonging to the protozoa group, they may lead to malaria, kalazar, sleeping sickness. I think out of these three, you would have definitely heard the term of malaria. And mm-hmm. there is a lot of, you know, government campaigns and awareness yes. things which are going on. Because the malaria, the primary thing and how malaria is developed is also because of the non-hygiene conditions.
Yes.
Because we all of us know that there is a mosquito, which is female Anopheles mosquito. It is the agent of malaria. It leads to the causing of malaria.
Right.
This is protozoan in nature because the protozoa is there. Plasmodium vivax is there in the salivary gland of this fly, that is mosquito. And when it bites, then it injects those protozoa, plasmodium, inside the body. And then there is a whole cycle along. There are major symptoms of malaria like high temperature, feeling very hot and shivery, headache and muscle pains and diarrhea. So it is always suggested that we should stop it in the first go. We should not allow the water to stand in our surrounding and we should not allow the eggs of the mosquito to develop so that we can stop the infection in the starting itself. Okay. There might be various worms, like there are various diseases which are caused by the worms, Escherichia, filariasis, hookworm infection. These are all infectious diseases. So I think in case of Escherichia, I can show you hookworm also, filariasis also. I have brought some visuals and which are showing out of that. In the middle, we can see that Escherichia condition is there, which is caused by a worm, which is known as Escherichia. And Rahulji, these are the major cause of, you know, which we call, आम भाषा में हम जिसको कहते हैं कि बच्चों के पेट में कीड़े पड़ गए हैं,
yes, yes.
तो ये कहा जाता है कि बच्चों को कीड़ों की दवा देनी चाहिए, स्कूल्स में भी दी जाती है एंड अदरवाइज आल्सो. सो वी सी इफ द रेट ऑफ इन्फेक्शन इज सो हाई दैट मेनी टाइम्स व्हेन चिल्ड्रन गो टू पॉटी दे गो टू लैट्रिन, वी सी दैट सो मच इन्फेक्शन इज देयर दैट दीज वर्म्स कैन बी सीन देयर आल्सो. एंड व्हेन द इन्फेक्शन इज सो हाई इट मे कम आउट थ्रू द स्नीजिंग एंड वीजिंग आल्सो थ्रू द रेस्पिरेटरी सिस्टम. So this is something which is we need to control because it actually compromises the health of the children. And again, the reason is the unhygienic conditions, and because of that, we get the infection. We get the eggs of the Escherichia, and then these eggs hatch, and then there is a multiplication of the entire cycle, which is going on.
डॉक्टर प्रियंका, मैं आपसे गुजारिश करूंगा, हमारा समय समाप्ति की ओर है, अगले 30 सेकंड में आप अपना सेशन कंक्लूड करें. एंड इफ यू हैव एनी कंक्लूजन रिमार्क्स फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स और द स्टूडेंट्स और द टीचर्स वुड लाइक टू प्लीज शेयर.
Yes, yes. And I think I am also almost at the end of my presentation, sir. So I think we've been able to manage the time.
Yes.
And really thank you for reminding me. So the last thing that I want to talk in this class is the means of spread. So as I already said, students, when we talk about infectious agent and the infectious diseases, there are various means of spreading, how they spread. So such diseases can be spread through the air, like, you know, when you're coughing, you are sneezing and you are not wearing the mask, or maybe somebody is standing very close to you, they may get the infection through the air. It may be through the water. If infected water is coming to your house, if there is no proper filtration of water, water hygiene is not maintained, the water is not purified, then you may get the infection of very many bacteria. And food, if the food is not hygienic, then it may be the cause of infectious agent, because it may carry certain bacteria in it, certain viruses in it, and it may lead to the infection. Mosquito, we have already discussed in case of malaria and dengue. We have seen that mosquitoes are the vector for it, and they are something that we really need to be cautious. We really need to contain and control the multiplication of mosquito, because we really don't know which mosquito might be carrying. And identification as such through the naked eye is very difficult. So really we need to control this.
Right.
And indirect causes में जैसे अगर कोई patient है उसके clothes से utensils को हम use कर रहे हैं, same glass में पानी पी रहे हैं, उससे हो सकता है. और AIDS के बारे में हम बात करते हैं तो sexual contact हुआ तो AIDS उससे भी होता है. Infected अगर injection को हम use कर रहे हैं तो वहाँ से भी हो सकता है. और अगर इन्फेक्टेड मदर हैं तो प्रेगनेंसी के टाइम पे या फिर ब्रेस्ट फीडिंग के टाइम पे बच्चे को इन्फेक्शन पास हो सकता है.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल.
रेबीज की जब हम बात करते हैं तो वो भी हम कहा जाता है कि अगर रेबिट डॉग आपको काट ले तो रेबीज हो सकता है. तो ये सारे डिफरेंट ये हैं. लास्ट मैं अपने प्रेजेंटेशन का करूंगी विद दिस डायग्राम, जिसमें ये एनसीईआरटी से ही मैंने लिया हुआ है, बिकॉज ये इतना ऐप था तो मुझे लगा मुझे यहीं से लेना चाहिए. इसमें हम क्लियरली देख सकते हैं कि कितने अलग अलग तरीकों से डिसीज एक ट्रांसमिट हो सकती है. And I would end my conversation, Rahulji, by saying that after knowing all the aspects of various factors which cause the disease, be it main immediate causes or be it contributing
Priyanka ji,
causes,
मुझे आपको यहाँ रोकना होगा. मुझे मालूम है कि ये तस्वीर बहुत important है, लेकिन अब समय बिल्कुल इजाजत नहीं
दे रहा है. बिल्कुल ये हो गया. मैं भी यहाँ पे बिल्कुल end ही कर रही हूँ. And I would like to thank you. And
right, right.
I would thank you all the learners.
और मुझे लग रहा है कि this session, you know, is gonna be a eye opener for all of us, including the class 9th students, जिनकी मदद से हम यहाँ पर health और hygiene की बात करेंगे. आपने ये science का session लिया, उसके लिए बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया, बहुत आभार आपका. Thank you very much for joining us. अगला session लेकर हम अभी हाजिर होंगे, जो कि उर्दू का है. देखते रहिए PME विद्या चैनल. नमस्कार.